I definitely look up to my sister. She has a lot of great things that I can learn from, and I think she's an awesome older sister. Ow.
Thank you, Maymay. Kimberly is my best friend. She's never going to be replaced.
I like to do martial arts, and then I also like to do basketball.
I like to do archery and play piano. I have a lot of favorite subjects. I like math and English and social studies and science and technology.
I like technology the best.
These are some of the programs that I did,
but I also really like science.
I like challenges. We saw some videos of people doing weather balloon launches online.
We thought that it would be a really fun family project to do.
A weather balloon is basically just a very large balloon.
They're used weather. To see what the weather is going to
be. So they send up different instruments attached to the bottom of the weather balloons.
And they'll transmit the data and saying, oh, it's gonna be partly cloudy.
There are 16,000 weather balloons launched every day around the world. The weather companies, the forecasters, only recover 30% of them. The other 70%
are still floating in space.
No, they're not.
Well,
they're still
popped.
Somewhere.
They're somewhere in the Earth.
Try not to interrupt me.
This is our Loki Lego launcher, the first spacecraft in the Young Stuff space program.
For the first launch, we didn't really have a goal.
We just wanted to get it off the ground.
We didn't really understand as much science then. We were kind of just letting go of it and hoping that
the calculations were right.
We call it the Loki Lego Launcher because Loki is our cat.
Our flight computer keeps track of a number of things, including altitude, latitude, longitude, speed, temperature, pressure, voltage, current, and power. There is a lot of data that we can learn from.
The first launch went to 78,000 feet. The images were awesome. When we first saw them, we screamed. It's just the blackness of space, and then there's Loki sitting there in the middle of it, right on the horizon. The first media that kind of wrote an article about us was a local tech news website called GeekWire. And then someone from the Washington Post saw it, and so they wrote an article about it. And then other people saw it, and they wrote articles about it.
You're gonna have to bring the Loki Lego launcher.
No! No! No way! No way! Seriously?
You're gonna meet the president.
Our parents told us that we were going to the White House Science Fair.
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to the White House.
When he actually walked through the doors, we were all in complete awe and, like, admiration.
Hey, guys.
Because this is President Obama.
He was really easy to talk to.
Yeah.
He was really friendly.
What do you guys have here?
So we built a spacecraft called the Loki Lego Launcher, and we sent it up to 78,000 feet.
That's crazy.
He talks to all of these, like, famous world leaders, and he makes decisions that affect the fate of our country. And we're just 9-11-year-old girls who did a science project.
This is a rough drawing of the flight computer. And we'll probably put the VI sensor here.
I'm making some changes to our original design because we're adding some new components and taking off some.
On the second launch, we added a bigger balloon because we wanted it to go higher and we also wanted it to go faster.
We added an APRS radio tracker, which sent us location and altitude data in almost real time.
However, the APRS might not be very accurate at ground level, so having the GPS unit as well is very helpful.
We rewired the voltage/current/power sensor so it would connect to a solar panel that we installed on our spacecraft to measure how much current it was getting from the sun. And we had a hypothesis that as our spacecraft went higher, we would have more solar current because we thought that since there's less particles in the air, it wouldn't block the sun's rays. The last thing that we changed was our Lego minifigure. We thought that she would be a good role model because she's a girl who's strong and she's brave and she doesn't give up even when things are hard.
Soon, it was time for launch.
We couldn't believe that it actually went 101,000 feet. I think we screamed again.
Our current data was really interesting because our solar panel was producing more current as the altitude was going up, which indicated that our hypothesis was correct.
Getting something correct, especially when you don't know that much about the subject, always feels good. I hope that more kids, especially girls, follow paths and do projects like ours in STEM. And I hope that our projects teach them that they can do whatever they want if they put their heart into it.
They don't have to stick with whatever is girly or boyish. Girls are awesome and girls can do anything.